Rediscover Aesthetics is all about making you look and feel your best. So combined with our three practitioners here, I'm a physician assistant of 15 years. We have a nurse practitioner and a registered nurse who are all ready and capable of handling all of your facial aesthetic needs, but as well as your medical wellness needs, such as medical weight loss, IV nutrition, even hormone replacement therapy.
Well, this is in a new year, and nobody needs to tell that to Melissa Stilley, the school superintendent, beginning that not just a new calendar year, but a new school year. In fact, school is just now taking back in after, well, a multi-week vacation.
Yes, it's been a kind of an extended vacation for our students, and so our teachers started back on Monday, Ken, and, you know, have been in professional development Monday and Tuesday. Our students will return on Wednesday, which is tomorrow. And we're excited about getting them back in school. We have some new teachers that have just graduated from college and in December, and they're starting their January off as their first year teacher. So we have quite a few of them sprinkled across the parish, and we're very excited to welcome them to Team Tangi as well. So, you know, January is almost as exciting as August because it feels like the start of a new year, but it's much cooler than August.
Don't mention cool weather because we were supposed to get our first real cold snap, but knock on wood. What will be different this year, if anything?
Well, we're kicking off in January with we have 38 school days before the state test. And so we will be kicking off our after-school program that we'll be doing for students that it's really targeted for students that are not on grade level or struggling in reading and math. And so we'll be kicking that off here in January. And then, you know, it's sort of like the 40 days of focus that we used to do years ago, but it's the last crunch time. It's 38 days before testing, state testing. We really ask our families and our students to focus in on attendance and being at school every day, being on time at school, and really soaking up the great instruction that they're getting in the classroom.
What do you think of the new governor's decision, his first one, as a matter of fact, in reversing the policy that allowed some students who couldn't pass LEAP to graduate? Now, that will not be so these accountability tests will be even more important.
Yeah, I think, you know, it's a pretty controversial topic. I mean, there's people who think that's a great idea, and then there's people, I mean, educators across the state think it's a bad idea. I do think that, you know, this sort of last minute, you know, what, 3 or 4 months before graduation, it is a huge deal for some of our seniors who need to pass the LEAP test. So my advice to seniors is to really focus and take advantage of every opportunity possible during this time of 38 days before testing to get those results that they need to, you know, walk across the stage in May.
So on the agenda tonight, more discussion of the Joyce Marie Moore case that's 50 years old, the desegregation case that we're almost out of, but almost only counts in hand grenades and horseshoes, after all.
So 58 years.
What do we need to do to get out of that case this year?
Well, I think we continue to do the work that we're doing, which is to focus on equity across the parish, to continue to provide every student in our parish with the very best education that they can possibly get. Focus on improving our facilities so that, because that impacts their educational experience. But I think we have the plan that we need, and we continue to work on the plan. You know, we have a plan, work the plan, and we'll continue to do that. I see progress in the case, and so we're excited. I think 2024 will be the year of the shift, and I think that we'll see a lot of things changing for the better here in 2024 for our school district.
Like what?
Well, I think we're going to see tremendous progress in the case. You know, I know that the federal judge makes that final decision, but I know that we're making great strides in the case. I think that we'll see improvements in our test scores with students, student achievement. Our teachers are working super hard. Our principals are working. They're focused in on the curriculum and preparing kids with what they need to know for the next grade level. We have a lot of assessments in place to help teachers know now how students are progressing through the school year. So I think 2024, there's just a lot of things that we've been working on for the last 5 or 6 years that we're going to see, begin to see a lot of dividends from that.
Well, in the last term, it looked as though we were finally making progress in fights and other things that were involved in discipline on campus. Have we finally got the discipline policy right, or did the trauma of the pandemic and our relation to it, did that finally wear off a bit?
Well, I'm not really sure if it's the pandemic wearing off or if it's the discipline policies, but I do see a shift in that as well. I think we'll see in this new year, in 2024, less of that. I think there's policies in place to protect and to really just sort of discourage any fights on campus.
What else do you want to share with us?
Well, January is school board recognition month, and so, you know, we have 9 school board members that are elected officials that represent all the areas across this parish, and, you know, I just want to thank them for what they do every day. You know, many of them have other jobs that they do, and this is something that they do because they care about students and, you know, improving education, and they get a whole whopping $800 a month for doing this job of school board member. They are not included on any pay raises that happen in the district. You know, no cost of living raises. I mean, that's set by the state, which is $800, and I can promise you that they put in a lot more time than that. And they also make a lot of donations to different little nonprofit agencies that, you know, need, you know, $200 for bitty ball or whatever. So they may get the $800 a month, but they give it back, and so to the community. So we want to thank them for what they do in educating our kids.
I don't know how this happened, but, you know, a parish councilman makes 3 times the salary of a school board member.
I'm not sure how that happened either, but the school board member salary or stipend, whatever you want to call it, of $800, is set by the state, and it's capped off. And so even if we, you know, wanted to give them more, I mean, the board could not even vote themselves a raise. So that's not possible.
Hi, I'm Trent Anthony with Monument Real Estate. After working several years in the real estate industry, I decided to serve the wonderful people of Southeast Louisiana by opening a locally owned company where each client is treated with a tremendous amount of respect and importance. Serving the North Shore, Baton Rouge, and New Orleans regions, Monument has the ability to broker all types of real estate transactions. Your real estate needs are very important to us, so let me or one of our team members help you make your mark with Monument Real Estate.